Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Allen Worship Experience. We're so glad that you decided to worship with us this morning. We welcome those of you who are worshiping with us online, and for those of you who are here, we invite you, come on, stand to your feet. For those of you who are online, go ahead and enter into the chat, lift up your praise, let us know where you're watching from, but let's head right into worship for this powerful worship experience.
Somebody came to lift up the name of Jesus. Why don't you just begin to open your mouth and give God praise? You know, something amazing happened this morning. The Lord woke you up. Do you not know that was amazing? Because somebody didn't get up this morning. So I came into the house of God to give God praise for everything He's already done. I'm not even concerned about what's coming, because what's already happened is good enough for me to give Him glory. Come on, just begin to lift your hands. God, we bless you and we praise you. We came in the building with a praise. We didn't come with a complaint. We came to lift you up and give you glory. I don't know how we got into this silent worship, but we will open our mouths and give you praise, because you're worthy. You weren't silent when you healed us. You weren't silent when you brought us out of depression. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody tell him thank you. That's a mighty weak thank you for a great God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Let your mouth say something in the house of God. He's been better to you than you could ever imagine. Somebody give God praise. Begin to praise him. Come on. Clap your hands. Talk fast. Say something. Hallelujah! Don't let your feet be cemented to the floor today, but give God glory with all that you have and all that we are. We will bless the Lord. Anybody came to bless him? Come on a little louder. Say glory! Come on, glory, Jesus! I need your glory in my life. I need your glory in my healing. I need your glory in my restoration. Glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. You ought to have 1,000 thank yous coming out of your mouth. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. If a song never plays, I still got to praise. Glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm gonna praise him for me. You can't praise him for what he did for me. I can't praise him for what he did for you, but it's worthy. Good God. Thank you, Jesus. Open your mouth and tell him, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Is there anybody that's excited about his goodness this morning? Come on, lift up your hands, open up your mouth and say, Father, have your way this morning. Come on, come on, let him enter into this place this morning. Hallelujah. We come to celebrate him. Clap those hands. Open up your mouth and shout hallelujah. Song says, you are God and you're in control. You see,
you're seated high,
you're Lord of all,
is stronger. God, you are higher than any other.
Come on.
Our God is here, awesome in power. Our God,
yes, Lord.
Our God, one voice. Our God is greater.
Our God is greater.
He's strong.
Our God is stronger.
He's higher.
Everybody in the building.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord our God. Hallelujah. How many of you know that every praise is to our God? And we give him praise today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, we come to you saying thank you for all that you've done for us. Hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together and bless him. God, we praise your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, God. We come to the throne of grace saying thank you. We come before you asking that you forgive us, asking that you wash us, asking that you cleanse us, asking that you purify us. Oh, God, we bless your holy name. Everything that we do it, God, to glorify you. So even right now, God, in the name of Jesus, God, we lift our hands before you saying thank you. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for giving us the right mind. Thank you for giving us the right spirit. Thank you for giving us the right heart. We bless your name today because you did not allow our enemies to triumph over us, but you've given us power to destroy, God, the very works of the enemy. And so today we say thank you. We invite you in, Holy Spirit. Have your way in this place. Move, God, throughout every pew. Move, God, from every breast to breast, every heart to heart. Touch, God, the minds of your people so that when we leave here, we'll be changed. Oh, God, we're praying today that you will move in such a way that we will be transformed, that we will be transitioned, that we will be moved from one place to the next, that we will go from level to level and glory to glory. Oh, God, in Jesus' name, we bind up everything that's not like you. Right now, God, the enemy cannot move, but your angels are encamped around us, watching over us, even right now. So we declare and decree that shackles are broken. We declare and decree that bondages are loosed. We declare and decree that minds are set free for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray and we give you praise. Come on and put your hands together in agreement if you believe the word of God. Hallelujah.
Thank you. lead my life, lead every day. I want to go with him when he comes back.
My soul cries out, thank you. My soul cries out glory. My soul cries out hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, hey, hey. The Lord is great and greatly to be praised. Amen. We greet you today with the joy of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Why don't you just look at somebody and just tell them, I'm a blessed woman. I'm a blessed man. Come on, just testify a little bit. The Lord is good. Amen. We're so happy to be able to be in the sanctuary on today. Amen. While you're up, won't you just thank God for our guest preacher for this morning, the Reverend Claudette Anderson Copeland, who'll be joining us at the 9 o'clock hour. Reverend Dr. Cynthia Hale, who will be preaching at the 11:30 hour. Reverend Dr. Gina Marcia Stewart, who's gonna sing the sermonic solo. I'm just kidding, just kidding. We are so happy my girlfriends are here, and I am so honored. It's been 3 years since I've seen Copeland, and I was glad to see her last night. And we thank God, almost 3 years, and we thank God that though her flight was delayed, it did take off and land. Amen. So grateful, so grateful. Just a few announcements. Mobile COVID testing is available today until 4 o'clock p.m. and it will continue Tuesday through Friday. Not tomorrow, but Tuesday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Amen, amen. I'm reading here that prayer is canceled on tomorrow night and will resume on Tuesday. Our 8 o'clock prayer call will be canceled for tomorrow night. And we will resume on Tuesday. I hope you have been joining us for our Throwback Thursday broadcast. We ask you to continue to view it. It has been certainly a lot of fun to look at. We're beginning our 2022 Bible study series, Let All the People Praise You, O God, which begins Wednesday, July 16th. And we would that you would look at the website. Some of our speakers are Dr. Turner, Reverend Jordan, Reverend Aisha, Brother Stanley, Sister Karen Farnham, and others. We hope that you will look at this series. It is, it begins Wednesday at 7 o'clock p.m., Wednesday the 16th, not this Wednesday, but Wednesday the 16th at 7 o'clock p.m. Well, we are going to have a farmer's market. We are in New York, but we're going to have a farmer's market, believe it or not, on July 16th at 9 o'clock a.m. Is that right? July 16th at 9 o'clock a.m. in the church parking lot. We're going to have a farmer's market. We're going to have cows and pigs and... No, we're going to have fresh produce. Is that good enough? Amen. Fresh produce and a few other things. So please put that day down and plan to stop by and buy some and support our brothers and sisters, amen, in their local businesses. So that's exciting. And then we're having Vacation Bible School July 11th through the 21st. We have daytime sessions and nighttime sessions. Parents, you may register your children. Grandparents, you may register your grandchildren online, www.allencathedral.org. And we are revving up for Dance Conference 2022, Worship and Arts Conference 2022. July 27th through the 30th, amen. The guest preachers for our evening services will be Pastor John Hanna, Bishop Marvin Sapp, and Bishop Jason Nelson. We are excited. We are looking forward to seeing you. And again, I say, if there are any pastors viewing, won't you please send some of you, the members of your liturgical dance ministry. We will give you a group discount, but we'd love to see you here. We'd love to see you here July 27th through the 30th for Worship Conference 2022. Amen. And we are preparing for our sneaker and backpack giveaway. Now, we need you parents, if you are registering and you would like a pair of sneakers, you have to register in particular and give us the correct size for your young person, and we will be happy to accommodate you. That backpack giveaway will be the last Saturday. I don't see the date here, but it's the last Saturday in August, and we need you to register immediately so that we can prepare. We can call the sneaker distributor and we can register sneakers for your children. And of course, we're looking forward to the backpack giveaway, giving away the backpacks. I think there's a registration there. But listen, there's so much going on here at Allen, and we hope that you will look at the website and avail yourselves to all of the offerings that we have as a church. God continues to move. God continues to give us work to do. We're excited about some things that are happening. We are soon going to start construction on the Shekinah elevator. And so all of that being said, it is giving time at the cathedral. It is giving time at the cathedral. It is giving time at the cathedral, and we hope that you will continue to support your church. And we need you to understand that we have come through this pandemic, amen, and the giving was strong. Now, the giving doesn't need to lighten up just because we are coming out of the pandemic. Somebody say amen. And I say that because many times we spend God's money on things that we shouldn't. Amen. God has asked for a portion of our income. Am I right? Am I right? Bring the tithe, bring offerings into the storehouse, into the house of God. And whether you go on vacation or not, amen, you're still supposed to support God's house. Hey, am I right? So we need you to give, and we need you to give generously. I mentioned the sneaker. We have to purchase sneakers. We have to purchase backpacks. There are no government funds for that. That's all your contributions. And so we need you to give, and to give generously in this time. Summer is here. God is, anybody in here can testify you've been kept by the grace and the mercies of God. Amen. God is keeping us even through the high cost of gas. Amen. Even through the high cost of food, you have been kept. Did anybody in here miss a meal? Did everybody eat yesterday something? Even if you ate Frosted Flakes, Corn Flakes, or Cheerios, you ate. So what I'm trying to say is that we need you to give. We need you to continue to support this church. The giving instructions are on the screen for those of you who will be giving virtually, in our virtual audience and in the sanctuary. If you're giving virtually, the giving information is before you. For those of you who are here and you're giving in person, you want to leave your envelope with us. Hold your offering until the end of the service, and the officers will be there to receive your gifts. If you'd like to mail in, and many of you have been so faithful in mailing in your tithes and offerings, you can mail it to the Greater Allen Cathedral, 110-31 Floyd H. Flake Boulevard, formerly Merrick Boulevard, Jamaica, New York, zip code 11433. We pray that you will have a great day today and tomorrow. We pray that you will be safe, and we pray that you will always remember that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen.
Romans 8:28 says, and we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, things are going to work out for you. Come on, I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, things are going to work out for you. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what you're facing today. I don't care what you got to face for the rest of this week. Tell somebody, it's going to work out for me. It's going to work out for me. Why? Because God promised me. It's a promise from God. Tell somebody, things are going to work out.
The race is not given to the swift, nor to the strong, but to the
The Spirit of the Lord is here. Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here. You better ask somebody. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Can't you feel it? The Spirit of the Lord is here. Come on, church. The Spirit of the Lord brings life. The Spirit of the Lord brings life. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord God Almighty, he brings life. Do I have a church this morning? You ought to let him bring your life right now. Let him bring your life right now. Whatever you need is in the room this morning. Let him bring you life. Oh, yes. Right now. We go into the word, but I want to remind you, the Spirit of the Lord brings health. He'll heal your body. The Spirit of the Lord brings health. The Spirit of the Lord, brings life. Come on and clap your hands if you believe it. The Spirit of the Lord is here behind that mask. The Spirit of the Lord is here to do what you need done. The Spirit of the Lord, hallelujah, is here. Clap your hands if you know it. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. He's here. He's here. Come on, Zion. He's here. Walking up and down your pew. The Lord is here. The Lord is here. Oh, the Lord is here. All in the balcony. The Lord is here. Shibadada. The Lord is here. He'll do what you need done. The Lord is here. He's here to heal your body. Here to heal your mind. The Lord is here. Yeah. The Lord is here. Oh, the Lord is here. Right here. Right here. Right here. Right here. Wherever you stand. Whatever you stand in need of. Glory, 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 right here. Oh, yeah, he's right here. Glory, glory, glory. So great God, we give you praise this morning. And we magnify your name. You are great God and we love you. Our souls magnify you. There is none like you in all the earth. You're God alone. You're God all by yourself. You're God alone. Hallelujah. And we magnify you. And we bless you. And we say you're a wonder in our souls. Oh, we lean hard into you this morning. And we say, have your way. Oh, God, we lean hard into you. We want to hear from you. Drop a word into our lives. Redirect our pathways. Correct us where we're off. Oh, God, encourage us where we're doing right. Strengthen us where we're weak. Lift up every bowed down head. Oh, my God, and when we're done here, we will glorify you. And we'll say you did the work. Through Christ the Lord we pray. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
amen and amen. Clap your hands in the sanctuary. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To the angel of this house, the Reverend Dr. Margaret Elaine Flake, senior pastor of the Allen Cathedral, clap your hands for the woman of God. How we bless the Lord for my good girlfriend, for her leadership, for her integrity in the gospel, for the word of the Lord in her mouth, and for these 2.5 years that the Lord has kept us while we've been absent one from another. We give God praise for her life. To the Reverend Dr. Floyd H. Flake, co-founder of this great ministry, we bless him right where he is and we thank God for him. To the great officers and members of this church, and to the preacher for the hour at 11 o'clock, none other than the president of the Hampton Ministers Conference, the pastor of the Ray of Hope Church in Atlanta, Georgia, Dr. Cynthia Hale. Those of you that are online this morning, you better stay tuned, for there is a word. And to my good girlfriend from Memphis, Tennessee, Reverend Gina Marcia, who will hurt you with the word of the Lord in her mouth. Pastor Gina, we thank God for you all. To the word of the Lord, all of these marvelous musicians, how we bless you. I've missed y'all. I've missed y'all. And I thank God for what you do in this place. Be seated in the sanctuary. I suppose there is a homiletically correct way to preach. You're supposed to do your scripture at the beginning and not at the end. Y'all stay with me. We won't be before you long. Let the words of our mouth, Lord, and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in thy sight. You are strength and our redeemer. Psalms 90 and 12 says, Lord, teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. The contemporary English version puts it this way, teach us to use wisely all the time that we have. I'm going to simply weave this thought into the little lesson that I've come to share and trust that you will be blessed by it. In this post-pandemic age, in this time when we have all been caused to come aside and to rethink the stewardship of our lives, I was sitting in an amusement park one night with my good girlfriend, and the sun had gone down. We were doing some people watching, and we saw the folks going in and out, enjoying the rides. And the Lord began to talk to me. Now, this issue of time and the circularity of it and the ways in which God will remind you of God's message, it might show up anywhere. Somebody say the amusement park. And I was struck by this contraption called the Ferris wheel. The Ferris wheel. Wheels, wheels. For those of you who think that I am not scripturally sound, wheels are tucked away in the landscape of Scripture. Somebody say, wheels. Exodus 14, it was the Egyptians pursuing the children of Israel into the sea, and God looked down and
cause the wheels to come off their chariots. Pharaoh's army got drowned in the Red Sea. If you remember the story of Judges and Sisera, whose iron chariots became bogged down in the wheels that trapped him in the mud and caused him to detour over to his death at Jael's tent. The wheels came off. Who doesn't remember Jeremiah down at the potter's house where he witnesses the potter at work on the wheel? Wheels of transformation with clay. On the wheel, God creates, and on the wheel, God corrects. I told you that wheels are tucked away in the landscape of Scripture. Who didn't go to Sunday school and learn about the bizarre prophet Ezekiel, who had a vision of the wheel in the middle of the wheel? And in that text in Ezekiel 1, the refrain is this, that the spirit of the living creature was in the wheel. Wheels full of eyes foretold coming judgment. Wheels are tucked away, tucked away, tucked away in the landscape of Scripture. For those of you that don't read the Bible, you watch Wheel of Fortune. For those of you who don't pay attention, your grandbaby rides a big wheel. I came through the airport, Dr. Flake, in a wheelchair. In Western thought, we live linear lives. We start at point A and end up at point B. We start at point A and we end up at point B in Western thought. But in African philosophy, life is not linear, but life is circular. We have come from God and we are pilgrims here, but we go back to God because life is circular. Life is lived in wheel. The wheel of life and eternity are inextricably bound. And so that night when I was at the amusement park with my good girlfriend, as we were people watching, I saw something called the Ferris wheel. The famed architect Daniel Burnham in 1890 was tasked to outdo this thing that had happened in Paris a few years earlier called the Eiffel Tower. And Daniel Burnham gave his team of architects and engineers one directive. And the directive was this: make no small plans. No one in the USA had had an answer to Mr. Eiffel's spectacle. So the name George Washington Gale Ferris Jr. means nothing to most of us, but in 1893, this 33-year-old engineer from Pittsburgh had heard Mr. Burnham's challenge. This young man had a vision and he betted success on it. He invested $25,000 of his own funds, found engineers and investors, and invented the first Ferris wheel for the Chicago World's Fair in 1893. 1.4 million people experienced that invention that year, and his name is forever known, Ferris Wheel. Though he died 4 years later, his invention lives on. Many of the great cities in the world have some facsimile of the Ferris Wheel. The Washington Harbor and the London Eye and Dubai and the New York Staten Island, always as a reminder, as a parable, as kind of a symbol that we live in the cycle of life. The wheel is always tied up, natural with spiritual, eternal with fading. We live in the wheel of life. Somebody say the wheel of life. So more than an amusement park ride or an urban tourist attraction, the Ferris wheel has an important message this morning to this and to every succeeding generation. And so if I were to have a, Dr. Gina is a homiletician. She is one of the premier homileticians of this hour. So I know, Dr. Gina, I'm supposed to have a title. Write your title on your tape. There is a cycle to every life. The gospel according to the Ferris wheel. Lord, teach us to number our days. Lord, teach us to use wisely all the time we have in this circularity called time. So the gospel according to the Ferris wheel, I just want to drop a few things on you, and then we're all going to get ready for the 11:30 service. Somebody nod your head if you're in here this morning. Somebody put something in the chat and let us know that you're here. The gospel according to the Ferris wheel, the cycle of life. First of all, as I sat there watching the people at the Ferris wheel line, the first thing I realized was, number one, there is a cost to ride. There's a cost to ride. You gotta pay it. There's a cost to ride. Listen, life demands a reciprocity. Cost imbues value. In other words, what you get in, you're gonna put out. The first Ferris wheel in 1893 cost the rider 50 cents for a 20-minute ride and gave access to an aerial view that most people had never seen. But the ride was not free. Listen, however long the ride or how abbreviated the time here on this earth, in living we must pay the rent. There's a cost to ride. And the rent, I suggest to you, is service to all mankind. The hymn writer put it this way, to serve this present age, a calling to fulfill. Is anybody here? May it all my powers engage to do my master's will. Service, service, service. It costs to ride, it costs to ride. You can be in line, but if you're gonna get on this ride, you're gonna have to pay something. And I suggest to you that the cost that is demanded of you and me is the cost of service. Service without grudging. Service without an ulterior motive. Service without sucking your teeth. Service, come on out of here, devil. It is the cost we pay to get on the ride. I found something out that people who serve you without love will get even with you behind your back. Service with love. Service. Serving, when we serve somebody else, it drives out despair from their lives. When we serve somebody else, it creates worth and value in somebody who feels like they've been overlooked and underappreciated. Service, it's the cost we pay to get on the ride. Jesus, you say you want to be like him, but Jesus took a towel, divested himself of his divinity, and served even those who did not deserve to be served. You gotta pay the cost to ride on this wheel. Secondly, I learned watching the gospel according to this Ferris wheel, not only does it cost to ride, but it reminded me of the challenge to go up. The Ferris wheel, when you get on, immediately it begins to take you somewhere. Go up. Go up despite those around you who may stand on the sideline. You go up. on this ride, you may become queasy on the ascent. Keep going up. Breathe through it and keep going up. You might get on it and have second thoughts about your decision. Keep going up. Baby, it's too late to get off in midair now. The Lord has called you to go up. Is anybody here? Others will be on the ground standing around with opinions about your ride. Go up. My friend in London, Dr. Adejomo, she said, Copeland, you got to remember this, that when you on the top, you become the topic. Keep going up anyhow. This ride is designed to take us somewhere. Keep on aspiring and keep on reaching and keep on believing for what is ahead of you. Somebody holler, go up! On this ride, you paid to get on. Now come on and go up. My mother used to talk about her high school down in Deep Georgia, and one of the mottos they had at the TJL, the high school, was reach for the stars. You might reach the treetops. Keep going up. On the way up, there will be stops and starts. There will be setbacks and seasonal droughts. On the way up, there will be blind alleys. Going up, you will second guess your decision and you'll want to jump off. Come on here. But stay in your seat and just keep going up. You had faith to start. Now you will need faith to stay. Come on and grow. Come on and grow up. Come on and grow great. Grow great for the greater good. Listen, go up. Great people introduce us to higher facts and higher causes and higher spiritual reality. Small people introduce us to themselves. You go up for the greater good. On the wheel of life, the stewardship of the ride says, pay the cost. And choose not to be afraid to go up. Teach us how to number our days aright, that we might gain a heart of wisdom. Grow up, go up unto him who is the head, even Jesus Christ. Thirdly, and if you get happy, I'll hurry up. We'll all be finished and we can go to communion. The third thing I see in the gospel according to the Ferris wheel, the stewardship of life, the circularity of what God has put us in, is the third thing I see is when the people were in line getting ready to pay the cost to get on the Ferris wheel, usually they were riding with somebody. Thirdly, don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. That first Ferris wheel carried 60 persons per cycle. You and I may never fit 60 persons on our own emotional pallet, but you're blessed if you have one or two or three. You're blessed if you have one or two or three who matter and who stick with you in your life. Jesus had the 70 as his fan base. He had 12 in his working team who helped him give birth to vision. He had 3 in his personal confidential space, and he had 1 who, with whom he was intimately connected, the disciple whom he loved. Whatever your choice, don't choose to ride alone. In this legacy of the pandemic, we have normalized distance. In this legacy of the pandemic, we have become afraid of the embrace of one another. Come on here. We have sanctified aloneness. We have perpetuated this virtual disconnection. Baby, you're gonna need somebody. Behind your mask, behind your screen, you're going to need human connection. Don't ride alone. I know you got church hurt. You are among the de-churched and the unchurched and don't want to come back to church. But I'm going to tell you, there's going to come a time in your journey around the sun when you're going to need somebody. Somebody say, well, I don't need nobody but Jesus. You're going to need Jesus with skin on. Don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. You're going to need somebody. The old teaching used to tell us that you're going to need somebody to hold you and to comfort you, to remind you that they're on your side in spite of Judas and in spite of Judges. You're going to need somebody. Going to need one to comfort you, one to collaborate with you. Come on, one to confront you and one to clarify your muddled mind. One, the comforter is for the heart. Let me tell you what, we got broken-hearted people in church. We got broken heart. We serving, but our hearts are broken. We got broken-hearted people in church. We've been molested. We've been abandoned. We've been denied. They borrowed our money and wouldn't pay it back. But you're going to need somebody to hold you close and tell you, baby, things are going to get better. Gonna need a comforter. Gonna need a comforter for the heart, a collaborator for the labor. You don't just want to labor by yourself. You need somebody to labor with you, to break the rocks. Come on here, to create something new in the midst of something old. You're gonna need a comforter for the heart and a collaborator for the labor. Gonna need a comforter for the correction. I know nobody wants to be corrected anymore, but without chastisement, the Bible says we are bastards and not sons. You're going to need somebody to confront you. Don't travel alone on this life cycle. Don't travel. You're going to need a comforter. You're going to need a collaborator. You're going to need, my God, a confronter. Somebody to tell you the butt naked truth. I said the butt naked truth. Somebody who's not impressed with your title and your spirituality and because you speak in tongues. No, they're going to speak in English and tell you, baby, you're wrong. Get yourself together. You're going to need a comforter and a collaborator, but you're going to need a confronter to tell you, get yourself together. Get right. Get on back in church. Oh, my God, everybody in here is not against you. Hey, everybody in here ain't a hypocrite. Come on, you. Don't you ride alone. Gonna need a clarifier to help you when your mind is muddied and confused. I got to hurry on, but somebody holler, teach us how to number our days while we're going around the sun on the wheel of life. Don't be afraid to ride with somebody. A friend will divide your sorrow. A friend will lighten your load. A friend, my God, will keep your bad kids when Bubba leaves you. A friend will hold on to you in your sick room. You need somebody to ride. Don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. Don't ride alone. And if you believe this gospel, if you believe what we're in, I know that there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. You might not have learned to trust people, but learn how to trust the God of our salvation. He said, look at here, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. I'm the one, my God, that'll take you through the fire and the fire won't burn you. I'm the one, my God, that'll walk with you through the flood and the flood will not overflow you. Learn how to trust God and then a few good people. Don't ride alone. 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 I got to hurry up out of here. But somebody holler, teach us how to manage the time we have been given on this cycle of life. Fourth thing, if this matters to anybody, while I'm on this Ferris wheel, I done paid the price. I'm on my way up, whether y'all like it or not. I got a few folks in my posse that's riding along with me. Ain't got to take everybody, but I'm going to take somebody. And then the fourth thing is I decided, enjoy the journey. going on the Ferris wheel on the way up. My God, there is a visceral decision that we must make. Enjoy the journey. My question is, on the journey, where are you living? Are you living in the past? So stuck in regret and unforgiveness? And angry about what God has allowed? Are you living so mired in the past? God calling you upward and forward, but you can't go forward because you're tethered to the injuries and the unfairness of your yesterdays. Where are you living so that you can't enjoy the journey, my God, that you're engaged in right now? Where are you living? Are you so tethered to who didn't love you right? Till when God sends the right lover across your pathway, you're so defended against love, you can't enjoy the journey. Are you living in the past? Where are you living? Or are you living in a future that is so full of anxiety and fear? Where you living so that you can't enjoy the journey right now? Enjoy the journey. Learn from all that has been, and be strengthened by faith to what is to come, so you can enjoy the journey right now. Some soldiers, some military, were over in Afghanistan, and they went there to liberate the women from the bondage of lack of education and lack of access to employment and lack of access to drive, and they did a fairly decent job in Afghanistan liberating the women. And then some months later, some of the soldiers went back to Afghanistan to check on the status of the women. And they found, when they went back to Afghanistan, that the women were still walking several steps behind the men. And so the brothers wanted to know, said, well, now we did all this work to make you free to enjoy your journey. Why are you still walking behind? And one of the ladies said to the brothers, we are walking behind the men because of landmines. Enjoy the journey, learn from what has been, and have faith for what is to come. And in the meantime, walk where you can walk and enjoy the journey. Somebody clap your hands and say, on this cycle of life, on your way up, enjoy the journey. I'm about to be done. Stay with me. You online, don't go away, don't turn it off. But listen, the fifth thing, I know it's not homiletically correct to have all these points. Y'all gonna forget five of them anyway. Maybe you'll hold on to one or two. Enjoy the journey. Who don't like it? I'm sorry. Landmines. Fifth, what do we learn as we're applying our hearts to it? We learn on that Ferris wheel. Number five, and this resonates with me at this time of my life. When I watch them going around, the fifth thing that I see in learning the wisdom of how to govern my life is that the top is a quick stop. It's a quick stop. The air is clear at the top. And the vision is breathtaking at the top. And everyone on the ground is pointing up to you once they see you have reached the top. And at the top, baby, whatever your top is, I want to encourage you this morning, rejoice, because it's a quick stop. At the top, be glad for all you've achieved. At the top, enjoy purpose and praise God for all that God has allowed. Yet remember this, that the top is a quick stop. Life is short, and you won't stay up there forever. It's a quick stop. Life will take you to the top of your vocation, the top of your love life, the top of your religious life, the top of your ministry. But baby, if you look at the Ferris wheel, you'll notice that it's a quick stop. And you don't stay up there forever. Health fades. Friends get away. Scandals uncover our hidden mistakes. We become dated and out of style. Oh, my question is at the top, who did you bring with you? And did you understand that you didn't come up there to stay forever? Don't get too proud at the top. Don't get too proud at the top. Don't become forgetful of those who trot out tributaries for you to get to the top. Don't discard your wife of 20 years who helped you get to the top of your career because you done found you a little filly who thinks you're wonderful on the top. May I tell you that she ain't gonna stick with you when your stuff don't work no more. The top is a quick stop. It's a quick stop. You won't stay there forever. Who did you bring with you and who did you appreciate who helped you get there? I was with Dr. Melva Sampson the other day and she was unpacking this thing about Ubuntu. It's not just an African philosophy, but Ubuntu means this. Look at here, look at here, look at here. In terms of this community of ours, if you're on the ground, then I'm still on the ground. If you're outside, then I'm still outside. If you're rejected, then I'm still rejected. If you're hungry, then I'm hungry. The fact is I can't get to the top and get amnesia about everybody else who did not get up there with me. The top is a quick stop. It's a quick stop, it's a quick stop. And you won't be there forever. Finally, what I've learned at almost 70 years old, I look good, don't I? The Ferris wheel, the Ferris wheel. What I learned, number six, is that lessons are clearer on the way down. I was real smart when I was 22. I was real smart when I was 35. I was smart, but I had no wisdom. Knowledge mixed with experience. Lord, teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Lessons are clearer on the way down. Don't grieve when your position changes. Don't grieve when the power differential shifts. Don't grieve. Come on here. I know some of these young girls, they cute, they smart, and they got all kind of PhDs and everything. And sometime the enemy will cause you, if you're over 50, to begin to wonder if you still matter. But then I really realize they might be cute and they might be switching and they might have two or three lovers, but they ain't got what I got. Because my lessons have become incorporated into the viscera of my walk with God. Oh, I know now what they have yet to learn. I know now what God will do, even though they just heard about it. Oh, I've learned now that although y'all are learning it, I have mastered it. The lessons become clearer on the way down. Praise him, and praise should intensify on the way down. And so I'm gone. But if there's a seventh thing that I learned listening to the gospel of the Ferris wheel, when I watched the people come around and around and around, and the lessons had been learned and the visions had been incorporated, you know what I found out? The last thing I learned is you got to be prepared to give up your seat. Don't die in your seat. Get out the way so somebody else can sit in it. Get out the way so somebody else can contribute to this present age. And when you get up out of your seat and you begin to walk, oh my God, back into the amusement park of life, somebody's gonna ask you, how was the ride? Have a positive confession in your mouth. Oh, baby, you can do this thing. Ride it, baby, ride. Touch your friend and say, ride it, baby, ride it, ride it, ride it. Give up your seat and make way, make room for somebody else to ride. I've had my share. I've had my fun. I've had my love. I've had my contribution. Now come on, baby, and ride, 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 ride. And I'm gonna be here watching you, clapping for you, telling you that you can do this thing. Hallelujah. Teach us how to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. This too, my brother and my sister, is the word of the Lord. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, amen, and amen, and amen, and amen, and amen. Come on and get on board. If you're not saved, pay the price. If you're a backslider, come on and get back in the wheel. If you're outside the church, come on back in, because God wants to take you somewhere. And there's a seat saved just for you. Our hands are lifted, our hearts are open. Our hands are lifted, our hearts are open. As we get ready to go to the Lord's table, before you leave this house, remember, it's not just point A to point B, but we are pilgrims in the circularity of time and eternity. You're a pilgrim and you're headed somewhere. There was a convention in hell one time, and the devil wanted to know, how can we get more souls down here? They had a renovation project. They had expanded the borders of hell. And he wanted to know, how could he fill up the coffers? Had a convention, and one of the little demons came up to him and said, look here, I know how we'll get more people down here. We'll tell them God does not love them. The devil said, you a fool. Crazy as some of them people I have been, and the Lord didn't kill me. They know God loves them. Another demon said to him, well, look at here, we'll tell them that there is no God, period. He said, you a fool. All they got to do is look out and see the magnificence of the sky, the trees, the firmament of his power. They know there's a God. He said, I'm sick of y'all. Get out of my office. And one little imp came and knocked on the door and said, well, your evilness, sir, I have a strategy that will help us. He said, what you want, boy, what you want? He said, well, we'll tell them God loves them. We'll tell them that there is a God who is a wonder. And matter of fact, we'll even tell them to go to church and get on the praise team and work in religious context. We'll tell them to do everything that religious people do. But when it comes to commitment to the Lord Jesus, we'll tell them they got time. Lord, teach us to number our days while we still have time.
Won't you put your hands together and thank God for the word? What a wonderful reminder that God is with us all the days of our lives, and that we have to enjoy the ride and know that God has us here for a purpose. Thank God for the Reverend Dr. Claudette Anderson Copeland. I thank God that she came up, amen, to worship with us on this day that the Lord has made, amen. And for those of you who are viewing with us, for those of you who are here in the sanctuary, we're going to just stop and take a little time for you to remember, to ponder what she has said. And we hope and pray that if you need to commit, that today will be the day of your commitment. And so as the music ministry sings, we want to know if there anyone who wants to come and commit your life to Jesus Christ. You're on this Ferris wheel, but you need Jesus to go on the ride. Amen. You need Jesus. I was young and now I'm old. I got older yesterday, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken. And so know this, my brothers and my sisters, you need the Lord with you on this ride. And so as the ministers come, we're just going to sing briefly. If you'd like to make that commitment, if you know you need to make that commitment, won't you do it now? Won't you do it now? Teach us to number our days, understanding that tomorrow is not promised. And if God gives me an opportunity today, I need to seize the moment and I need to avail myself to that opportunity. And I need to do that which is right for my life. And so we ask you today that if you're here and you've never given your life to Christ, if you would just come, begin to walk down the steps if you're in the balcony. Walk from the back, walk from the front, wherever you are. But this is the day that you can change your life forever. This is the day that you can become someone brand new. Hallelujah. Won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come? Jesus is waiting. Don't hesitate. Won't you come? If you're viewing with us, the instructions are on the screen. You can text the word salvation to the number that is there. If you're ready to give your life to Christ, you need to text the word salvation, and we will be in touch with you next week to lead you to the process. Hallelujah. If you just like to become a part of our church family, you can text the word membership to the number that is on the screen. And we will be happy to contact you next week and make sure that you are a part of the Greater Allen Cathedral family. Don't hesitate. You need Jesus. You need Jesus. Is there one here? Please. God bless you, my sister. She has come. Is there another? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. He's waiting for you.
He's waiting for you.
He's waiting just for you. He brought you here today.
So
so that you can make that change that really matters. Hallelujah. If you're afraid to walk, ask someone to walk with you, but you need to do this for yourself. We're going to sing it one more time. Come to Jesus, my brothers, my sister. My brother, my sister, come today. He's waiting just for you. Jesus is waiting. Oh, don't hesitate. Hallelujah. Won't you put your hands together even as another sister comes? God, we thank you for the word that has gone forth. We thank you for these who have answered the call to commitment. And we pray, God, that if there be anyone who was hesitant, anyone who just could not do what they should have done, that you will trouble them. So that in the next day, in the next few days, they will become who you created them to be. And that is indeed a child of the Most High God. God, we give it over to you today. And we count it as done. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's put our heads together and thank God for these two who have come. For those who have joined us virtually, we thank God for you. And certainly, again, we thank God for this day that the Lord has made. Let us prepare our hearts and minds now to receive the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The hour is late, but we're going to take time to pray the general confession. Won't you join me? Almighty God, Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, maker of all things and judge of all people, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and we're heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The very remembrance of them is grievous unto us. So, Lord, have mercy upon us. Most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Bible says that on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took his bread and he gave it to his disciples and said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. And as often as you eat, you do so in remembrance of me." And so we eat today the bread, the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, remembering that he was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. They beat him, they pierced him in the side, but he gave his life that we might be here today. Let us eat with joy. But even more, let us eat with thanksgiving, knowing that he could have come down, but he did not come down from the cross. Let the people of God say amen. The blood that Jesus shed, he shed for you and for me. This blood shall never lose its power. So we drink today with thanksgiving. We thank the Lord. We thank the Lord. As we depart from this place, we go forth singing the hymn of the church.
Pastor Elaine, I wouldn't normally do this, but you just celebrated a birthday yesterday. And we want to thank God, amen. Come on, we're going to celebrate. We're going to sing happy birthday. Y'all know she doesn't like this much attention, but we're going to do it anyway.
Come on, hymn of the church.
And then we'll sing the hymn of the church. Amen. Come on. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. God bless you with many, many, many more years. Hallelujah. May God bless all of you and keep you under the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, teach us to number our days. We thank you, oh God, for every day is a day of thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you all. God bless you. Have a wonderful Sunday.
COVID testing is held Sundays until 4 p.m., Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Thursdays from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Registration is open for our sneaker giveaway. Register today online on our website. Save the date for our back-to-school book bag and sneaker giveaway Saturday, August 27th. Registration for our book bag giveaway will open soon. Tune in this Thursday for another Throwback Thursday broadcast featuring Pastor Emeritus Reverend Dr. Floyd H. Flake. Join us virtually at 8:45 p.m. for a look back at some of your favorite moments from the Allen Worship Experience. Stream on our Facebook page, YouTube page, and church app. Register today for Vacation Bible School, July 11th through the 15th and July 19th through the 21st. The theme is Making Waves. What you do today can change the world around you. All activities are in person. For more information regarding our virtual, hybrid, and on-site events, please visit our website at www.allencathedral.org.
Thank you for worshiping with us today. We invite you to stay connected with us on our website at allencathedral.org and across our social platforms, including our YouTube channel, Facebook page, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. Listen to our daily prayers, watch Bible studies, see featured videos, give tithes and offerings, and more on our mobile app, which you can download from iTunes or Google Play. Subscribe to receive our weekly digital event calendar and text alerts by visiting our website at allencathedral.org and follow the prompts to subscribe. You are invited to join us on our live audio prayer line weeknights 8 p.m. to 8:20 p.m. and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. The dial-in details are available on our website. Again, we are so grateful for the opportunity to worship with you today. Our church continues to slowly open its doors, keeping your health and safety in mind. Remember, you are the church. To God be the glory. Have a blessed day.